supaya dia main bagus. Tuh kan jadinya fall out kan?
Jadi it always sucks to lose, like, you know what I mean? Like it never feels good to lose, but I think we went out on a high note. You know what I mean? It's something to be proud of. That's all I told him.
Yo, what's up, school fans, and welcome back to the vlog. And it's gonna be my last vlog tonight from IBL this season. So let's make it a good one tonight. Hopefully game akan seru. Semoga akan ditentukan sampai detik-detik akhir. And tonight we're gonna watch game 3 IBL playoff antara Borneo Hornbills melawan Dewa United. Kita akan lihat nih apakah Dewa bisa comeback setelah tertinggal 0-1 kemarin ini, atau akan ada the biggest history ever in the IBL playoff. Oh my god, can't wait sih. Very excited though for tonight's game. I'm gonna enjoy this one. Akan sedih juga sih meninggalkan IBL saat lagi seru-serunya, but it's okay. Kita akan ngikutin nanti mungkin lewat live chat as always. And once again, I just want to say thank you guys for always supporting the channel for the whole season. Really appreciate you. Semoga kalian juga enjoy dengan vlog-vlog gue dari IBL Games. Kalau gitu guys, gue udah telat banget nih. Tadi abis upload timeout dulu, gue udah nyampe kayak 40 menitan sebelum game. So once again, I just want to say thank you so much for watching. Jangan lupa untuk like, jangan lupa untuk comment, and let's go in and enjoy the game, guys.
Thank you. keren sih Coach Miles sih. Still coaching till the end. Keren sih.
Pasti bagus gitu ya ngelihat, biasanya ini kan IBL menyelenggarakan fans IBL. Nah ini kita ngelihat fansnya Borneo, fansnya Dewa hari ini, kemarin fansnya Prawira. Jadi terpecah-pecah tapi fanatismenya makin tinggi kan. Nah itu yang pengen kita lain dengan sistem open way ini. Ya mudah-mudahan kan ini terus naik, memang perlu waktu. Tapi kalau kita lihat 2 minggu ini ya sesuai yang kita harapkan lah.
Waktu itu alasan pertamanya kenapa mau pakai wasit asing saat lagi playoff?
Ya kan kita lihat ya evaluasi juga, terus kita tahu season ini dibanding season yang lalu ini intensitinya sangat tinggi sekali. Kita ada indikator-indikator yang menunjukkan itu, dan playoff kita harus siapin sesuatu supaya gamenya lebih enak ditonton, lebih menarik, lebih mengedukasi kita juga tentang game ya. Makanya kan dari sini bukan sekedar kita pakai asing, tapi apa yang bisa kita pelajari dari mereka supaya next season kita bisa ambil ilmunya, bisa kita upgrade lagi.
So far feedbacknya kok dari tim-tim semua tentang wasit asing?
Oke, dan secara teknik sebetulnya asing dengan lokal nggak terlalu jauh gitu. Tapi ada yang beberapa hal kita perlu upgrade, yang cara komunikasinya, gestur menjelaskan kepada setiap situasi yang ada. Nah itu yang kita perlu pelajarin. Beda karakter, Jepang beda, Bahrain beda, Cina beda juga. Nah ini kan bagus kan semuanya buat kita.
Thank you, Pak. Sukses untuk playoff ya.
Gimana? Seru nggak nge-vlognya hari ini?
Apa?
Hari ini nge-vlognya seru nggak?
Wah, seru. Deg-degan sih.
Deg-degan? Jangan lupa, guys. Subscribe.
Altaf.
Nah.
Underscore satuku. Oke?
Okay. Gimana, Ram? Udah lancar lo interviewnya?
Apa?
Interview-interview udah lancar belum?
Ya, bisa lah.
Suara ya.
Deg-degan dikit, tapi bisa.
Coach. Just how nice is it to see Galvis, I think, got his fire back and start bouncing around, hitting threes, scoring 37 points before playing against SM?
You know, I've known Galvis for a while now, from Latin America. It's the first time we are together, but I've coached against him in playoff and elimination games. He kicked my butt. He has great resiliency to in this kind of moments to refuse to lose. He's a guy who refuses to lose, and in the big moments he has the ability to step up and really carry ourselves in the offensive end in a great way. He had a huge impact scoring the ball and from outside, from drives, from the free throw line, from a lot of different aspects, and obviously gave us a great boost in order to win this game.
Can you just talk about a little bit about the upcoming matchup with Satria Muda? What kind of problems they always give you guys?
Well, Satria Muda is a team that's changed their shape absolutely since they signed these three new foreigners. They are, I know Reynaldo Garcia from Argentina. He's a great player, dominated the league when he was there. Strong, quick hands, can score, can play defense. Already knows Asia because he's been playing in Japan. And Bustovi and Cook are coming from Spain First Division, which is the best league in the world outside the NBA. So they present a lot of different matchup problems for us. They are on a roll. Even though they lost that game against Solo, they won 12 of their last 13. Their locals feel a lot more confident now with the new foreigners. They are playing with a lot more confidence. In order for us to compete against them, we will have to play mistakes free. Because when we played here the last game of regular season, we didn't have a good game, and every time we made a mistake, they made us pay. So we will have to be really locked in order to make the series competitive.
All right.
Good luck, last
night. Your daddy's a beast. You're going to be a beast, too. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be a beast, too, girl. Stay focused and listen to mom. All right? Don't be shy.
Baju lihat.
Hah?
Baju lihat dong.
Kok bajunya?
Iya, kenapa pakai prosper? Nah.
Supaya dia main bagus. Tuh kan jadinya fall out kan?
Jadi yang fall out. Berarti di jinx nih sama kaos lu. Galvis, welcome back. You got your swag back tonight.
Always been there.
I feel like you got your fire back. I haven't seen you scream like that in a while after scoring a three, so what was your mindset going into this game?
Win. Just gotta win. You know, it was gotta give it to Borneo though. Them boys never threw in the towel. Usually a lot of teams would have threw in the towel in certain times of the game, but them boys just kept coming, so shout out to them for that.
And what can you take away though from this first round, you know, heading to the next round against the big team SM?
Just being consistent, you know, having a lot of energy, coming out prepared, focused, you know, but mostly it's effort and energy.
And can you just talk about the upcoming matchup, you know, with Ronaldo, obviously?
I mean, I've played against Ronaldo since 2016, so it's not the first time I see him. Mm-hmm. Very good guard, so it's going to be a really fun matchup.
All right, Galvis, thank you so much, man.
Okay.
Good luck.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to see you next season.
Lumayan
kita dapat jersey tanda tangan. Terima kasih Dewa United sudah support giveaway kali ini. Tanda tangan oleh Galvis Solano yang hari ini cetak 37 poin. Hari ini special untuk my members.
We fight. Kita melawan. apa yang mereka kasih kita lawan, kita kasih perlawanan down 10, down 12, down
19,
kita tetap lawan. Itu yang saya bangga sama pemain-pemain ini. Itu sih.
I lost my voice, man. That's why I use my
voice. So, yeah, anything to say? Yeah, well, first I just start with, just want to give God the glory just for this season. Just being starting from the bottom and working our way back up to where we at now. So very grateful, so glory to God for that. We fought. It was a great series. We punched them. And when we was at home, we protected our house. We did what we were supposed to do. And the next two games, they did what they supposed to do at their house. So they had more home games than us, so they ended up winning. That's the way I look at it.
Coach, kapan suaranya hilang?
Tadi malam.
Tadi malam?
Tadi malam. Tadi malam udah mulai. Tapi hari ini lebih lagi.
Kita pertama mau nanya dulu deh tentang menurut coach, obviously dua pemain lokal step up, ada Orlando, ada Calvin. Selama series ini bagaimana coach lihat perkembangan permainannya mereka dan juga confident level mereka?
Bangga banget ya, cukup puas nih mereka mau ngelawan. Bayangin.
Mungkin pakai mic coach.
Tahun lalu si Orlando sama Chrysler minute play-nya dikit. Sekarang dia bisa step up. Gimana kita enggak puas, pasti puas banget dong.
Coach kan nggak dari awal season ya, coach masuk pertengahan season waktu ngambil head coaching job ini. Untuk coach secara overall season ini seberapa happy dan juga apa yang mau disiapkan untuk musim depan?
Happy banget, puas banget, puas untuk karir pertama saya sebagai pelatih kepala. Saya bersyukur saya bisa sampai di sini. Saya bisa ngalahin juara regular season kemarin sekali aja bersyukur banget. Kalau untuk musim depan, banyak yang harus dibicarakan dengan pemain yang ada, manajemen dan owner. Kita mau melangkah sampai di mana? Itu sih.
But, I think for us it was we didn't get enough stops. That was part of our identity. That's what made us be able to go from being at the bottom of the standings to at the top. We get stops and we go to the basket, you know, we play in transition. To play in transition, you have to get stops, and that was our identity. And they made a lot of shots, they made a lot of tough shots too. So the free throws, you know, you're gonna miss free throws at times, especially when you're on the road. You don't know the rims, it's different. You don't have enough days here to always be perfect. But the defense, you can control that. You can't control free throws sometimes.
Yeah. And also, I like the matchups that Coach Milo put you against Gavis, even though, yeah, he's a little crazy out there.
Yep.
But how you see him?
Oh, Galvis is an amazing player. He's an amazing player, great talent. So a lot of people don't know me. Galvis is from the same community.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he's been a great talent since he was a kid. And to be able to play against him now and coach, you know, put me on him. Right now, I can't really appreciate it like I want to.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I know, like, you know, later on, people in our community, when they see the pictures and stuff like that, it's going to mean a lot. He's a great talent. I got nothing to say bad about him. I hope he continues to be great and continue to be healthy.
Of course, like everybody wants to know, like, how's the next season?
How's the next season? Oof, man. For me, it's always up. All right, so here's the thing. No matter how many times I prove that I can play at this league or any other league, once I get on a plane, everybody, once my agents start calling people, they say you're too old. That's you're too old, right? And I can't fight the politics forever. You know what I'm saying? That's politics, you know? But every year I come back, I prove it over and over again that I can play at any level. And this year, coach gave me a role where he wanted to make usage of my minutes to be effective. I was very effective this year. Coming off the bench, it was different because I was used to putting Rams on my back for 2 years.
Yeah.
So to come here, lower my ego, and be the backup for Mike and Steve, and come in and do as much as I can for those minutes, it was a great experience. I actually started enjoying it, playing 94 feet, defense and stuff like that. So to be honest, bro, I don't really know. I don't know what's going to happen. I can't control, you know, everything else. But for me, I'll be in shape. I'll stay in shape. and my wife gives me the A-OK, like, go ahead, do it again, then I'll be ready.
Thank you. Kim, what would you tell? Kim, what would you tell Orlando to improve on for this offseason? I know you are very close with him, you know, and he's playing on the same position like you. What would you tell him?
So, first, I just want to tell him, young dude is brave. He's brave. You got to understand something. To wake up one day and go from shooting guard to point guard, it is not easy. It's the hardest transition in basketball because you have to think differently. And that's hard to reprogram yourself on the fly, you know? That takes time. When I did it, I was a shooting guard coming out of college. When I got to Finland, it took a Serbian coach 2 years to teach me how to play point guard. So that's going to take time for him. But I will tell him that that just start watching a lot of video on himself. Mm. That helps the growth. Watch video on other point guards. Try to figure out what type of point guard he wants to be. You want to be like a Luka. You want to be a JJ Barrera or a Kyrie. Figure it out how you want to look, you know? And then after a while, start taking steps, get the right people around you. Borneo will do a great job of putting the right people around him, try to form him into a point guard that he wants to be, not what they want him to be, right? Because it's still about creativity within yourself, because this is a sport. So you want to look in the mirror and be like, yeah, I'm playing like how I want to play, you know? So that's what I would tell him. Start with video, start chopping it up, try to figure it out, use your imagination, how you want to look, and then go towards that.
My God, appreciate you, man.
It's been real, man. I saw you standing in the middle of the court after the game. What went through your mind?
For me, it's bigger than basketball, you know? Being able to play, you know, one last time, you know? Being blessed to get on the court, being free of injury, you know, God blessed me with another chance to play. You know, I just look at all that, you know? So I was just standing there just thinking about, I'm blessed to be here. It's a lot of dudes that don't get a chance to play, and I get that opportunity. So, you know, I'm just taking it all in like that, you know. I look at basketball a lot different, you know. Where I'm from, a lot of dudes don't make it out. So being able to come here and play, you know, put on for the one team that believed in me. You know, all these teams didn't believe in me, but they know who I am now. So I just look at it like that.
I see you got tears in your eyes. Yeah. And this is obviously not the result that you wanted, but just how proud of you of this group, man.
Yeah. I just, you know, I enjoy playing basketball. So, you know, losing always hard for me. I'm a sore loser. But, you know, I woke up this morning. There's a lot of dudes that didn't wake up this morning, so I'm thankful, you know. So, you know, I'm just glad, you know, Indonesia gave me a chance to play. So it's just hard for me to walk away knowing I lost, knowing I gave my all, you know.
But playing next to Mike, Akeem, how was it, man, all year long?
It was good going to war with them guys, man. I go to war with them any day, man, you know? And, you know, we changed the narrative here. Because, you know, at the beginning of the season, when I got here, what were we, 0-7, 0-8?
0-7.
No, nobody believed in us, because that don't happen. Making it to the playoffs after being 0-7, that never happens. So, you know, I'm happy, man. I couldn't be more happy. These happy tears, these happy tears, you know?
Always good vibes, man. Appreciate
you. Good vibes, you know
good
me.
Good vibe, man.
Thank you, bro.
Hope you're coming back next season, bro.
Let's see. All right. Let's see. I'm in competition with Gojack, so if you need me, call me. The app is going to launch in about 2 weeks. So just know that we coming.
Can you just talk about the journey that you had this season and how proud of this group?
Man, hey, I'm so proud of these guys. You know, I came into this situation and it was just tough, you know what I mean? It was just a dark cloud over the team. When we started winning and turning things around, it was just a beautiful thing, you know what I mean, bro? Like, it's good, bro. Like, nobody would have thought we would have been here. Think about it, we were playing elimination games probably like the last 2 months of the season. Like, all those games at the end of the season were must-win games. We came in, won the first game against Denver, bro. Like, we almost had a chance of winning this game. You can't really ask for more. You know, we were short-handed. We came out, I think they had a lot of heart, bro. So I just told them to hold their heads up. You know, it always sucks to lose, right? You know what I mean? Like, it never feels good to lose. But I think we went out on a high note. You know what I mean? It's something to be proud of. That's all I told them.
Can you just talk about this guy, Chrysler, and Orlando, just about their progress and their growth?
That's what I was telling them, about them and Doppler. I said, man, I saw them mature through the season. Man, they went from not playing to being in starting roles to being guys that we depended on, Calvin being our most trusted shooter. Bro, you know, through Sevely going down, man, that was major. You know, like, we really needed him, man. He really came out and showed heart, bro. So I'm real proud of my little brother, man. Both of them, man. Yeah, they good.
Thank you so much, Mike.
Thank you, bro.
Take care, appreciate you, bro. As always, bro. Alvin, perjalanannya berhenti di sini, tapi pastinya membanggakan lah dari 0-7 sampai kan bisa masuk babak playoff, ngalahin Dewa di game pertama. Kalau dari Calvin sendiri, gimana sih perjalanan season ini?
Perjalanan Borneo, kita dari start, kita ganti pelatih berapa kali udah 0-7, mulai sama Kamail sampai bisa lolos ke titik playoff ini udah kayak roller coaster banget lah. Kita ya bersyukur banget kita masih bisa masuk playoff di peringkat 8. Lebih bersyukur lagi kita bisa ngambil menang lawan Dewa walaupun kita kalah 2-1 hasilnya, tapi season ini great season lah buat kita semua Borneo.
Kalau dari Calvin mau ambil pelajaran apa yang bisa dibawa ke next season setelah season ini?
Pelajaran dari season ini sih kita udah ada di level, sekarang kita ada di level peringkat 8 nih. Next seasonnya kita gak boleh turun, kita harus naik. Ya, itulah.
Ini selama playoff ini kayak nembaknya lebih pede daripada regular season. Ada apa pas playoff ini?
Playoff ini ya dari Coach Mail juga selalu bilang kita udah gak punya opsi lagi. Ya pede mainnya, dia bilang tugas lu ya nembak, dia bilang. Kalau bisa ngedrive ya sekali-kali gak apa, cuma tugas lu intinya nembak, dia bilang. Mau dari jarak jauh atau deket, ya tembak aja, dia bilang. Karena dia percaya itu sih.
Ini jago loh, padahal pinggangnya sakit loh. Pinggang gak apa-apa nih?
Pinggang, lutut, dan...
sakit semua ya? Tadi juga kena ya?
Tadi ya, cuma tabrakan dikit lah, cuman masih bisa main.
Nih guys, congrats. Thank for you, a great season, tahun depan lebih bagus lagi.
Amin.
Dan pastinya nih bintangnya Borneo nih, Orlando sama Dava nih. Oke, okay. Good luck ya.
Thank you, bro. Okay.
That's it from me this season. Sebelum gue mengakhiri video terakhir gue dari this season di IBL, just want to say thank you kepada semuanya yang sudah selalu nonton vlog gue selama satu season ini. I had so much fun covering the IBL dari pre-season, regular season, playoff. Wanna say thank you juga kepada IBL, terutama kepada Pak Junas for his amazing work menurut gue this season. Bener-bener udah tinggi banget levelnya IBL sekarang ini, and makin seru aja ditontonnya. Of course, mau say thank you juga kepada semua IBL staff yang doing a great job the whole season untuk memastikan semuanya berjalan lancar dan juga sesuai harapan para fans. And wanna thank you also kepada semua pelatih, pemain, ownership, teams yang sudah membantu gue juga untuk membantu untuk gue buat konten every games. Thank you so much for all the access. Really appreciate them. Without them, gue nggak akan bisa sih untuk bikin konten-konten gue, vlog gue this whole season. Jadi, and once again, gue juga mau bilang thank you sekali lagi kepada kalian semua viewers, subscribers, members yang selalu mendukung gue satu season ini. It's sad, jujur sedih gak bisa nonton semifinal dan juga final IBL. This is my second time in 2 years, lalu miss the finals. But I got a chance to watch the Olympics. Tapi yang lebih penting sih bisa spend time with my dad di sana juga. That will be, karena gak selalu dapat kesempatan juga untuk bisa jalan-jalan bareng dia dan juga, you know, enjoy the Olympics with him. So I'll be back untuk nanti. Setelah the finals kita adalah ntar kita liput-liput, kita akan bikin trash talk lah ya, banyak lah ya, interview-interview pemain, kita akan feature pemain IBL during this off season. So ditunggu aja untuk kontennya. So once again, that's it from me, IBL season 2024, and I will see you guys again untuk vlog IBL in 2025 season. So once again, thank you so much guys for watching. Bye, I'm out.